franktalks.com.
Hello, my name is Frank Kermit. I am a hypnotherapist under the National Guild of Hypnotists. I'm making this video today in order to answer some commonly asked questions about hypnosis and hypnotherapy. If your questions or concerns are not covered in this video, please feel free to contact me directly, and I'll be happy to answer any and all questions you may have about hypnosis and hypnotherapy. So here are some commonly asked questions. First one, what is hypnosis? What is hypnotherapy? Hypnotherapy at its best is when the body is able to experience a state of deep physical relaxation while the mind experiences a sense of hyper-focus. In this altered state of awareness, the subconscious, sometimes called the unconscious mind, becomes open to new suggestions. Hypnotherapy is just one level on the spectrum of suggestion. Hypnotherapy is simply a tool used to program new suggestions at the core levels of your mind, and or to reprogram those already existing beliefs that were placed there when you were a child. People are their repeating behavior patterns, and most of those repeating behavior patterns started as beliefs at the core of your mind when you were a child seeking ways to make mental and emotional associations that would allow you, in the basic understanding of a child, to gain favor of the adults who were in charge of your immediate survival. When a misassociation is made, a child becomes an adult with a repeating behavior pattern and suffers. For example, a child who witnesses parents fighting over money may make the misassociation that money, not the lack of money, leads to a loss of love, and therefore becomes an adult that sabotages financial success as part of a repeating behavior pattern rooted in the mental-emotional association which was conceived in the mind of that child who only wanted to be loved and never abandoned. Hypnotherapy can be a tool that is used to identify such routes to repeating behavior patterns and program new beliefs directly into the subconscious of the adult and the inner child of the adult to make permanent and lasting changes. What are the benefits of hypnotherapy? What are the benefits of hypnosis? Hypnotherapy can help you change repeating behavior patterns, your habits, and help you tap into the helpful resources that are already embedded in your subconscious to meet that goal. Hypnotherapy can help you identify the core beliefs and misassociations that are at the root of a negative repeating behavior pattern. For some clients who need constant, regular reinforcement, hypnotherapy can be a quick and affordable means of getting that regular support to meet your goals. For a list of the different benefits of hypnotherapy, please visit franktalks.com. Click on the Hypnosis button in the menu and choose the page that lists all of the benefits of hypnotherapy. How can I tell when I'm hypnotized? It depends on the person. Some people know that they are hypnotized when they start to feel more relaxed. Others know they are hypnotized when they are able to start visualizing. Yet, others may never actually feel hypnotized in the moment, but later will acknowledge the state of hypnosis when they experience the results of hypnotherapy in their day-to-day real life. For example, when they recognize a post-hypnotic suggestion taking effect in their real life, that's when they understand that they were hypnotized. Is hypnosis real? Hypnosis is very real. It is a natural and normal state of the mind. We all experience states of hypnosis throughout every day of our lives. If your sensations and perceptions of the world have ever been altered through suggestions, well, that's what hypnosis is. The easiest example of this power of suggestion are the professions of advertising and marketing. Advertising is constantly suggesting, reinforced hypnosis, of one alternative over the other, so that when you're about to make a purchase, the ads that you were exposed to will influence you to choose one product over another. Marketing is about using the power of suggestion so that when you are asked to think about a particular product, a particular brand name is the first mental and emotional association you will make with that product. For example, if you are presented with the product of toothpaste or the service words of fights cavities, the brand names of certain companies will immediately come to your mind as being associated with those words. That's an example of real hypnosis. But why does hypnosis work? Hypnosis works because human beings are influenceable creatures. A person that sees someone being helpful to strangers, for example, helping someone fix a flat tire on the side of the road, may be influenced to do the same thing if they encounter a similarly stranded person down the road. Hypnotherapy and hypnosis is just a tool used to send suggestions directly into the subconscious with the directive to help the client. What is the difference between the conscious mind and the unconscious mind? The conscious mind is aware of objective reality and can denote the difference between the past, the present, and the future. The conscious mind is also able to clearly tell the difference between objective reality and a vivid fantasy. The conscious mind can tell the difference between real feelings that are a part of real life and the imagined feelings, such as those that come during a nightmare that wakes us up from our sleep. The conscious mind can only identify all the beliefs that we are already aware of, and it has an idea of what we should be doing, but the conscious mind cannot always explain why we don't always act in our best interest. The unconscious mind. The unconscious, also referred to as subconscious mind, cannot tell the difference between what is real and what is imagined. As far as the unconscious is concerned, it's all real. All events and all feelings associated with those events are as real as if they actually happened, even if you only imagine it. The unconscious mind also cannot tell the difference between the past, the present, and the future. As far as the unconscious is concerned, every moment in time is happening right now, at exactly the same time. That memory from last year, what is happening in the present moment, and that fantasy you have about what you hope is going to happen in the future, according to the subconscious, all of them are happening right now, at exactly the same time. For the first time, looking back from the future, and everything is happening in this exact moment. The unconscious mind is where all of our core beliefs, at the roots of our repeating behavior patterns, are stored. What does it feel like to be hypnotized? Does it feel good? For the most part, the majority of people report feeling very, very good right after a hypnotherapy session. Many report feeling rested, more confident, better than when they first started the actual session. For some people, the various body sensations and deep relaxation is what has the most impact. For others, they emerge from a hypnotic trance feeling different on an emotional level. Feelings such as feeling more hopeful, more joyous, more optimistic, and more motivated than when they first started the session can sometimes emerge. Can anyone be hypnotized? Most people can experience some level of hypnosis. People with the ability to focus and concentrate can go into a hypnotic state. Those that have greater capacities for focus and concentration are likely to go deeper and faster into hypnosis. The best hypnotherapy clients are those who are very willing to be hypnotized, who have an imagination, and who have taken the time to find the right hypnotherapist to develop a trusting bond with. Now, with that said, a person cannot be hypnotized against their will. Anyone who refuses to be hypnotized will simply not be hypnotized. It's just like how a person refuses to support a particular corporation and will not allow themselves to be swayed by advertising or marketing. It's up to the client and the hypnotherapist to work together to find the right kind of style and content of hypnotherapy that can best meet the needs of the client. Will I be asleep, or will I know what's going on around me? The answer is, no, you are not asleep. If you fall asleep, you are not experiencing hypnosis. You are always aware of everything that is happening around you, no matter how deeply you go into a guided meditation. You hear everything and your senses become hyper-focused. Hypnosis happens best at the point where you are in a state where you feel that you could fall asleep. But if you happen to actually fall asleep, you are past the point of actual hypnosis. Is hypnosis dangerous? Hypnosis is a tool, and like any tool, it can be considered to be a tool for creation or a tool for harm. This also includes hypnosis in the hands of someone that may have good intentions, but not the skill to use it in the best way. It all depends on the person who is using it. Be sure to check out the background and other credentials of the hypnotherapist you choose. Is hypnosis a form of mind control? No, hypnosis is not mind control. Although hypnosis and mind control, brainwashing, are both in different places on the spectrum of suggestion, mind control is about manipulation of the subject in ways that the subject would not consent to in a correct state of mind. The kind of mind control that people are normally afraid of require things like massive sleep deprivation, lack of nutritional substance, and happens over a long period of time. In hypnotherapy, the client is informed and then will be required to consent to everything that is suggested prior to being led into a hypnotic state. The client remains consciously awake and aware through the entire process. Will I lose control when I am under hypnosis and reveal any secrets? No, you will not lose control while you are under hypnosis. Hypnosis, by definition, requires the client to always be in control. Clients only reveal what they want to reveal. In the vast majority of the cases, clients reveal any information they feel is necessary for the hypnotherapist to know before the hypnosis session ever begins. How much will I remember or forget after I wake up? Most people remember everything that went on while they were in hypnosis, as long as they pay conscious attention to what was said. If the client is consciously distracted, then there may be no conscious memory of what was said, but there most certainly will be an unconscious memory of what was said. When practicing hypnosis, many hypnotherapists, such as myself, will repeat what does need to be remembered, as well as make suggestions to remember specific information. At the client's request, sometimes the hypnotherapist will suggest that they forget what happened until a post-hypnotic suggestion is enacted. However, this is strictly at the request of the client and only in very specific situations. In other cases, some clients enter the session with misconceptions about what hypnotherapy is, and they enter the session with their own suggestion that they must forget everything. In these cases, clients do not remember what was said due to the power of their own rooted inner beliefs. How deep into trance will I go? Although there are different systems to measure trance levels, the one that the NGH refers to most frequently is the 6 levels of trance. Levels 1, 2, and 3 are lighter levels of trance, and it's all that's necessary for the purpose of hypnotherapy. Levels 4, 5, and 6 are the deeper levels of trance, and that's what stage hypnotists seek in on-stage subjects. Does the hypnotherapist have any special powers? With all due respect to this question, if hypnotherapists had any sort of special powers to speak of, do you honestly think that any of them would be working at hourly rates with clients instead of more efficient ways of using such powers? I mean, really? Can the hypnotherapist make me do things against my will, like in the movies? No. A hypnotherapist cannot make you do anything against your will, your morality, your ethics, or make you do anything that you did not already have the capacity to do. What you have seen in the movies is fantasy. See the previous question about hypnotherapists having quote-unquote special powers. With all that being said, what is a surprise to many clients is just how vast their capacity to take certain actions actually are, and what their morals and ethics do in fact allow for. Most people really have not gone through a self-actualization process, so they do not really know how much they are actually capable of or what their limits actually are. Will I even wake up afterwards? And what happens if I don't wake up? Yes, you will surely wake up, because no one sleeps during hypnotherapy. Hypnotherapy, by definition, requires the client to be relaxed, but very much awake and alert throughout the entire process. If you fall asleep during a hypnotherapy session, it is not hypnosis. You are simply asleep, and you will wake up as you would any other time you fell asleep. Sorry if this next part offends anyone, but anyone that has ever remained asleep for an extended period of time, as in some of those sensationalized news stories of stage hypnosis subjects, have faked it. They were addicted to the drama of playing the subject that cannot be awakened, and stayed in trance because they committed to it to get attention. It's that or a publicity stunt. On occasion, some clients constantly choose to remain in trance because, well, it just feels good, and they wish to remain in a hypnotic state. There is no value to having clients remain asleep in hypnotherapy. True hypnotherapists would rather you emerge from your trance, pay your bill, and free up the space so that we can work on our next client. Do keep in mind that the hypnotherapist space you are sitting in requires that we pay rent on that space as well. What some hypnotherapists do is remind the client who refuses to come out of trance that they will be charged for an extra session of hypnotherapy as long as they stay in trance. Unsurprisingly, clients come out of trance very, very quickly upon hearing that information. Can I learn self-hypnosis? Yes. Most anyone can learn to do self-hypnosis. In fact, most people do it to themselves already without any formal training. For example, as a dating and relationship coach, I often advise singles not to fantasize too much about the new person they start dating, because that fantasizing is a form of self-hypnosis, and can only lead to disappointment when the reality discovered by the conscious mind on the actual date is unable to live up to the fantasy that the unconscious mind has programmed into the imagination subconscious. Self-hypnosis is also in the regular statements and questions we make to ourselves every day. If you ask yourself questions like, "How can I be so stupid? No one will ever find me attractive enough to date. I always choose the wrong people to date." In these cases, a person is actually practicing a form of self-hypnosis by giving themselves negative self-talk suggestions instead of those positive ones which would actually lead them to make better choices in their love life. I will teach you self-hypnosis during your second or third session after we deal with some of your core issues first, as suggested by the National Guild of Hypnotists.
FrankTalks.com. Need help with love, sex, dating and relationships? Visit FrankTalks.com.
What do you do when you feel like a fool? When your heart has been broken again? Pick up the phone or get onto Skype and talk on a private session. Yeah,
get a little help from Frank Talks.
Whoa, whoa, get by
with a
when your love goes away.
Try coaching one-on-one.
How do I sign up to turn things around?
Just sign up at franktalks.com.
Best rate going around. Yes, we're certain, just read the reviews.
Frank loves his stuff, and Frank's ever goods.
Good love can soon come to you.